Number 5. Carla from Utawaru Mono. What I find just as awesome as Carla's Herculean strength is her attitude about it. Her battle philosophy is, I'm 20 times stronger than you, and I don't really give a shit. Now you're gonna die. Then, of course, there's the sword she uses. Observe.
I heard that my order's finally ready.
Yes, it is ready, but there may be a small problem.
I can barely lift the stupid thing. There's no way you're gonna be able to use that.
I'm gonna go outside and give it a good test.
Yeah, that should explain a lot. But still, Carla isn't just about huge strength. She actually has a personality to her character as well. And also, when it comes to sake, she will drink it for hours without even breaking a sweat. So yeah, if you're a fan of drinking, I guess you'll like her a lot. Number 4. Train from Black Cat. A lot of the great animes have character development, and in my last top 10, I mentioned that Black Cat was a prime example of this. What I didn't really touch upon, though, is where Train started out and where he finished in this development spectrum. When the series started, Train was a masterful assassin known as the Black Cat, who was so good that he could practically shoot down a fly on a tree 100 yards away without killing it. Then after a huge plot twist in the series, he gives up his role as an assassin and becomes a bounty hunter, or a sweeper, if you will, who is hell-bent on carrying his revenge on Creed, the villain who, well, I won't spoil anything for you, but let's just say that what Creed did is not very nice. As the series progresses, you get to see Train slowly turn from a heartless monster into this cool guy with a strong sense of justice, and for some reason wears meat patties on his shirt? Okay?
I've come to deliver some bad luck.
You see, that scene was so kick-ass that I just forgot what I was talking about. It's that good. Number 3. Kazuma from Kaze no Stigma. Kaze no Stigma just barely fell short of making it on my top 20 anime. And I still stand by that decision. Don't get me wrong, I really enjoyed the anime. But let's face it, the plot is standard and forgettable, and often cheesy, as is the basic premise in general, and the main heroine, Ayano, is just obnoxious. She blows up over everything. And when your main heroine is that annoying, that can really take away from an anime's value. For me, it was Kazuma, the hero of the series, who saves it. And no, that sentence was not meant to be just a bad pun. No matter what genre of anime you're in, it's extremely rare to pull off a character who is not only your main lead, but is both badass at unbelievable levels and humorous at the same time. Without Kazuma, this anime would have sucked, but with him, it's pretty good. In fact, I think Kazuma's backstory was written by a different person. He's the only character with an actual backstory that is actually intricate and in-depth about his past. To give you an extremely basic summary, Kazuma was kicked out of his family for not being able to master fire magic. Yeah, there's magic in this anime, that's not really explained. But then, he comes back 2 years later as a frighteningly powerful user of wind magic, which is considered a scornful art, but he sure pulls it off and kicks everyone's ass with it. Everyone else? Prior to when the story takes place, they sort of just did stuff, I guess. Yeah, it's never really explained, like I said. A good scene that illustrates how cool Kazuma is probably the first scene in which he fights in. Observe.
Wrong house. Now eat this!
That's not a ghost, you idiot. It's a Yoma.
Please, save me! I'll pay double what I promise you, I swear!
If that's all, you don't put much value on your life.
I'll make it 10 times then! No, 50!
Have a nice day.
100 times!
So you do want to live, huh? I'm done. You got 3 days to get me the money.
Okay.
First fight scene in the anime, and already I love this guy. Even though I basically just took advantage of that poor old guy, he did it in such an awesome way that I still have a lot of respect for him. It's that kind of unexplainable coolness factor that gets you on this countdown in the first place. Number 2. Shana from Shakugan no Shana. If you remember my top 20 anime, you'll remember that I talked pretty extensively about how cool Shana was in it. As I said in that video, a chick with a sword already scores some points with me. But Shana is all that coolness of a chick with a sword on steroids. Even though she starts off as kind of a jerk, her character really develops over time. And to be fair, if you know a bit of her backstory, you'll start to understand why she acts like that and even forgive her for it. Even Shana's title, the Flame-Haired Blazing-Eyed Hunter, is just so cool that you'd think they couldn't pull it off. But they do. She really lives up to that name. Just the idea of a girl who uses a flaming sword is just epic to me. The whole concept of this character is amazing. And she would have been number one if it wasn't for, well, in my opinion, the most obvious number one on any countdown. At least it should be. But whatever. Let's just move on so we can finish this video, because this is getting way too long. And my number one coolest character of all time is Lelouch from Code Geass. It's hard to explain why I like this guy, because Lelouch is a character who I'm really drawn to, as are so many other people, but you can't really explain why. Maybe it's because he's a diabolical genius. Or maybe it's just that he's manipulating an entire group of rebels into taking down the largest empire the world's ever known, all by himself. Well, not by himself, he's got C2 to help him, as well as his Geass power. But the fact remains that throughout the entirety of the anime, Lelouch is always doing pretty terrible things. For example, when one of the generals from the rebellion refuses to work with him, he plants a bomb in his ship secretly, and in the middle of battle, he blows the living shit out of him. And he does it to make it look like the poor bastard committed suicide. Now, does that sound something like the title character of an anime would do? Still, I was rooting for Lelouch throughout the entire anime. If you want to know why, it's probably because I saw this scene in the second episode, which really drew me, as well as anyone who watched it, into the series. Now, for this scene to have its full effect, you need to know some backstory. Basically, one of the princes from Bichania has ordered his men to massacre a population of Japanese people. This is Lelouch's reaction to it once he gets one of their weapons.
The west entrance. Use the tracks to move to the west entrance.
Who's this? How do you know this code?
That doesn't matter. If you want to win, you're just going to have to trust me.
To win? Okay, what am I supposed to do now?
Since you trusted me, you're gonna win. Jump onto the train!
Gotcha!
If that's your plan, then... You, go after the Glasgow!
Yes, my lord!
What the...
And keep in mind, right now you're watching the abridged version. This scene in real life is like 10 minutes long.
Colin! What the hell was that radio message earlier?
What? He contacted you too?
Sure did. And Yoshida's group ought to be here soon.
Are you in charge?
Yeah.
I present to you the cargo in that train over there. They're tools for your victory. If you want to use them to win, then follow my orders.
They're There's more in here!
Here too!
This is wearing me out. Regardless, I'll need determination to succeed. After all, I'm betting my life in this game.
Anyway, if Q1 is on schedule, enemy Sutherlands, probably two of them will reach you in 23 seconds.
Shoot them through the wall.
3, 2, 1, fire!
What? An ID signal can be a double-edged sword. Besides, if the terrorists follow the orders I issue, my task at hand is sure to be completed.
P1, P4, P7, move 100 meters to the right and fire your slash Harkins toward 3 o'clock.
You heard him! Do what the voice says!
Damn, what else does he want us to do?
P5, ready?
Yeah. Quit calling me that! They're using the same...
R2, fire anchor. P7, use UN ordnance. End group, you'll continue your advance.
You 4011!
With this, I call check.
That's enough of that. Anyway, that scene should have spoken for itself. Luce is just so epically cool here that I had to root for him throughout the entire anime. Even if he's doing horrible things the whole time. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this top 10 as much as I did, because making it took a lot of effort. See you soon, next time I have another top 10.